Shown from our Viera wireless camera. Storm Tracker 13 meteorologist Sam Postich joins us now in for Mary tonight with your forecast. And it is a Friday, Sam, so what you got in store?
Well, thankfully, we'll be seeing all of that haze clear on out by tomorrow night and into our Sunday. So not the entire weekend will be plagued by smoky skies, just the start of it. Here's your Mortgage Solutions financial camera on North Union and Montebello. Pikes Peak is back there in the distance, and a little bit of haze in Colorado Springs. Our air qualities currently are listed at moderate. Further north you get into Colorado, the worse the air quality gets. Denver is still unhealthy for sensitive groups. And far southern Colorado over the Sangres is also listed at moderate. 71 in Alamosa, high 70s for Springfield. And all of us still pretty much sitting at our high temperatures for the day. Tomorrow we're dealing with a cold front that'll swing through the state that is actually just positioned in northern Colorado as we speak. I think this surface analysis graphic is just slightly ahead, as really the wind speeds are the strongest in northern Colorado and southern Wyoming, right on the line of that front. And over the next few hours, we'll be seeing wind shift to mostly northerly instead of this easterly direction across Los Angeles County and Colorado Springs. The northerly winds will continue to push all of that smoke further south and across the higher terrain. The first spots to clear on out will be Highway 50 in the eastern plains. Colorado Springs will get a quick burst of moderate haze, even to potentially dense haze by midnight tonight, but look at how quickly all of that smoke moves across I-25 and then clears on out by our 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. So yes, still some hazy skies potentially in Colorado Springs, but the worst of it will be in Teller County and Park County. So if you're driving up into the mountains, don't be surprised to see hazy skies, and then unhealthy air quality levels are still expected the closer you get to those fires from the Cameron Peak and the Mullen Fire. And if that's not bad enough, fire weather warnings in effect till 8 o'clock tonight for some of our mountain counties. Chaffee County, you're gusting to about 35 miles an hour over Monarch Pass with relative humidities in the single digits, so critical fire weather conditions in the mountainous terrain. 45 for your overnight low in La Junta, 42 for Colorado Springs, and for tomorrow's forecast, I just kept the haze in by 8 o'clock, but I wouldn't worry about it much for tomorrow afternoon. Mostly sunny skies and upper 60s for us, slightly cooler, more October-like for many. 74 in La Junta, upper 60s for Denver residents. And then by our Sunday, warming right back up, low 70s for Woodland Park, and then even 73 degrees by your Monday forecast, a trend that all of us are dealing with. The warming and also a dry spell, not a drop of rain in the forecast for the next 7 days. Hazy skies in Fremont County, mid 80s by Monday, even upper 80s in the forecast in Pueblo. Sunny through the first half of the week. Some increasing clouds by Thursday and Friday. I still think rain chances are pretty far out. Colorado Springs, upper 60s for our start of the weekend, and then low 80s by Monday. Plenty of sunshine. Guys.